first chauffeur, come and take me away. Cause I've been standing in this line for like 5 whole days. Me and security ain't getting along. And when I got to the front, they told me all of the tickets were gone. So just take me home where the mood is mellow, when the roses are thrown, M&Ms are yellow, and the light bulbs around my mirror don't flicker. Everybody gets a nice autograph picture, one for you and one for your sister, who had to work tonight but is an avid listener. Every song's a favorite song and mics don't feedback. All the reviewers say you need to go and see that. And everybody claps cause everybody is pleased. And then they all take the stage and start performing for me. Like ha 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 ha, ha 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 ha.
If you are what you say you are, a superstar, then have no fear. The camera's here and the microphones, and they wanna know. Oh, oh, oh. If you are what you say you are, a superstar, then have no fear. The crowd is here and the light.
Hey guys, welcome to Chicago and welcome to MTV's live coverage of the US premiere of Transformers: The Last Night.
Woo!
I'm Josh Horowitz alongside, of course,
Gabby Wilson.
And we are here for all the big action. Michael Bay's latest film, the fifth in the franchise, nearly $4 billion and counting.
And it's kind of an anniversary for the Transformers.
10 years in too, now.
Right?
10 years
yeah,
in.
Crazy.
And we both got to see it last night.
Right.
It is
and
huge.
It's full IMAX 3D glory.
It is epic in every way you would expect from a Transformers film. And for the next hour or so,
yeah,
we're going to talk to all the major stars. Who's coming, Gabby?
For sure. Mark Wahlberg, of course. Anthony Hopkins.
We just saw Anthony Hopkins, Josh Duhamel returning to the series, and also joining Gerard Carmichael. Big fan of the great comedian and actor Gerard Carmichael.
Yes, and some new people too. Isabella Moner.
Laura Haddock joining
yes,
the series. A lot of faces, and they're all going to be here in Chicago. I should say we're outside the beautiful Civic Opera building here in Chicago, overlooking the, we've got some excited fans saying hello to Sir Anthony Hopkins, and we're overlooking the beautiful Chicago River. And
Right, why are we in Chicago again?
Well, it's a big part of the franchise. I mean, of course, the Battle of Chicago, I think in the third film, occurred in Chicago. They've shot parts of the films here, and part of the new film takes place here in Chicago.
Sweet.
But before we get to some of the interviews with our big movie stars, shall we take a look at a trailer?
Yeah, let's go check out that trailer.
Okay, take a look.
They have been here forever, hidden in the shadows. To protect Earth from what was destined to arrive.
You are needed, sir.
For my world to live, Earth must die.
This is a new prime.
The final battle is upon us.
Transformers: The Last Night.
B, we better have some skills today, buddy.
B! You are out of your mind!
Rated PG-13, June 21st.
As you can see, the film is epic. Transformers: The Last Night. It's only fitting I'm joined by a knight himself, Sir Anthony Hopkins.
Thank
How
you.
Are you, sir? Good to see
Very
you.
Very good. This is my wife, Stella.
Very nice to meet you, Stella. Congratulations on being a part of this amazing series. Michael Bay is a very unique filmmaker. He makes summer blockbusters like nobody else. Was he a big part of the reason for coming aboard this one?
He's fast and furious. He's an amazing guy. And he's the reason I wanted to do the film. I didn't know what the script was, but I met him, and he told me all about it, and I knew, you know, he's the guy who... And so I said, yes, I'd love to do it. Then I got the script, and... I thought, this is an easy one.
There's a lot of fun stuff for you to do in this one. There's some fun dialogue between you and Mark. And
That's right, yes. And all my own stunts.
You also have kind of a robot manservant, in a way. Yeah. Is it kind of odd to play opposite? I would imagine there's a little bit of imagination involved in those scenes. Does that take a little bit of a leap for you as an actor, or does it come naturally?
We have a robot at home.
I'm a robot myself.
So does it feel like a different kind of a scale of filmmaking? You've obviously been on some very big films.
No difference. It's all in the mind. No, it's the great thing about Michael Bay and any great filmmaker like Michael or Spielberg or whoever they are is that they're fast, they get on with it, they don't mess about. No time for talk. You've got to be on your marks. You better know what you're doing because it won't be the idea if you don't. And I like that. I like that kind of preparation. It takes a lot of discipline. And to work with Mark Wahlberg is exactly the same. Very disciplined actor. And Laura Haddock and all of them. Just great, real professionals.
It must also be nice to be a part of, and you've been certainly a part of some movies that have really resonated on a massive scale. And this series of films, I mean, it's made almost $4 billion and counting. You know the fans are there for this series. Yeah. And to know that it resonates with them, that's got to be a big part of the reason to knowing that your work is going to affect people.
If a script is good and if a director is good, you know you... Just take your chance, and if it's a big box office, that's fine. But you don't consider all that stuff, otherwise you'd never get to work.
What would you say to an actor preparing to work on a Michael Bay Transformers film?
Know what you're doing. Know what you're doing, otherwise you'll be dead. Now, he's a great, great director, great filmmaker, and he expects you to show up. He expects you to be professional. And I say to any young actor, just get ready, learn your lines, show up and do it. Don't complain. Don't moan, don't be late, get on the set, do your job, and go home.
There you go. Good advice for any young actor out there. It's a great pleasure to see you. I think one of the testaments to this film series is the kind of talent that Michael has brought along from John Turturro, Mark Wahlberg, Stanley Tucci, to yourself. So we're thrilled to have you be a part of this, and I hope you enjoy your time in Chicago, sir.
Thank you so much.
Very nice to meet you, Stella. Thank you, sir. And of course, we're going to be talking to all the big stars today, but in the meantime, take a look at this piece of tape where we talk to some of the stars of Transformers. I believe this is talking about their emojis, right? Yeah, so we talked to them in Las Vegas recently, and they talked about sort of how they would define this Transformers film in emojis. Take a look at this. Okay, using the way we talk to each other nowadays, emojis, how would you define the new Transformers movie?
Well, I don't want to be basic and say the robot emoji. I think the heart emoji, because the Transformers have a heart, and they go through, like, inner battles in this one. And obviously the blue heart emoji, though, because that's my best friend Squeaks in the movie. We got fire sign for all the hot people in the movie. Have you seen Laura? She's so beautiful. She's so beautiful. And then we got the, what's it called? Oh, gosh. The alien face emoji, because they're aliens, the robots. But, yeah.
Summed it up perfectly. I don't need to see the movie. I feel like I just saw it.
No.
I know you love emojis. What emojis would you use to define this new Transformers movie?
Probably the chains and the blades. And the knives and the swords.
Fair enough.
All the weapons.
Probably the hands that are just like up like that. I just use that.
Your default?
The default, yeah. Those hands seem appropriate for almost any situation, though.
Scary face, pain face, like just joyous face, crying face. A heart, can I throw a heart in there? A monkey with the hands over the face, and then a unicorn, and then a robot. I don't know if there is a robot. And then a courgette.
And we are back live with Mr. Gerard Carmichael saying hello to some folks.
We're like on a tour here. Look at this thing. Hey, you guys. Hope we're not disrupting your vacation plans or anniversaries.
This is a first for me doing a world premiere red carpet next to a river in Chicago. That's a new one. That's a little bit different.
Interesting. It's like a helicopter up here, and I can't tell if like they're for or against us. I don't know if we're in danger or not.
You'll protect me, I'll protect you.
Oh, thank you. You say that, but you're a man in a blazer. I don't think there's much we could do.
Fair enough.
There's another, hey, look, a Shoreline Sightseeing. I just plugged them for no reason. Hey, Shoreline Sightseeing.
They're not a sponsor. You don't have to do that, man.
No, everybody's kind of a sponsor.
Congratulations on being a part of this amazing film series, man. Give me a sense of when you sign on to something like this. Is this kind of like was this ever on the checklist for you to be in a film of this scale, a summer blockbuster, like a Transformers film?
No, it was like a surprise. Yeah, it really, for me, you know, I got a call. I wanted to work with Michael Bay. I thought, you know, I think he's a great director. He's one of those directors where you could tell his work within 10 seconds of viewing it. So, you know, as a kid, I was more of a fan of him than Transformers, to be honest with you. So I was excited to work with him, and here we are.
Is it a big leap, too? Because it takes a certain kind of acting. You're having to use your imagination a great deal.
Yeah,
is that something, like, do you feel like a crazy person when you're talking to things that aren't there? How do you kind of make that leap?
Oh, yeah, you feel insane. A little, but it's fun. You know, it's a fun experience. I think that's part of it. You know, you do these things, and it's a lot of practical things, a lot of explosions happening around. So you had a lot to interact with.
I saw the film last night in IMAX 3D. It's epic. I mean, even as far as summer blockbusters go, it's insane.
Big, right?
Yeah. What's it like for you to see yourself as a part of this? Is it kind of fun to kind of like see? I mean, the shots are gorgeous. You look like everybody looks so heroic in a Michael Bay film,
right?
Yeah,
that's what's fun. You know, Michael only does hero shots, you know, so it's really fun to do that, to see that.
You're never going to look cooler than in a Michael Bay film.
I know, right? I know. He's got to do my headshots.
Are you good with stunts? What's your level of action performing? Are you a budding action star?
I'm more of a, what's the type of actor that drinks mint tea in his dressing room? I'm more of that guy.
Not Mark Wahlberg, I think.
Yeah. I'm the other guy then.
Was there anything intense you had to do that kind of scared you a little bit?
Nothing really scary that I remember. I think it was just it was a lot of running. It was a bit exhausting. You know, I'm skinny, but I'm not that in shape.
Right.
Yeah, you learn that the hard way.
Do you immediately get on with someone like Mark Wahlberg? Is he your speed? Mark gets along with everybody, I feel like.
Come on, he's rich and successful. He's nice.
He's a good friend to have.
Yeah, he's very nice. He's a really good guy. Yeah.
Who in your family is most impressed by you being in a Transformers film, you think?
Probably my nephew. He's here. I don't know. He was running a little late. He'll be around here pretty soon. My nephew really likes it. He finds it really exciting. So, you know, did it to work with Michael Bay and for him.
You got some cool uncle points. Congratulations.
Yeah, a little bit.
It's always good to see you, buddy. Congratulations.
See,
Gerard Carmichael.
Make Josh tell you what this means. It means something, and he's not letting us know.
Maybe by the end of the live stream, I'll let people know. I don't know. Good to see you, buddy.
Good to see you.
Have a good one. More stars coming up from Transformers of the Last Night. We've been talking about the amazing director of this series, Michael Bay. Had a chance to talk to all the stars about working with him here recently. Take a look at this. Is there a craziest day on a Michael Bay film, or is every day a little bit insane?
Every day is shocking. You know, you got a new type of crazy. Whether it's you're being sprayed with water, you're putting out a fire, you're blowing up Stonehenge. Like, it's just insane stuff. Everything never ceases to amaze you or excite you. So like everyone on set, whether there's 400 men or two girls, like everyone's excited and amazed, and you feel like a little kid.
Every day is insane, and then some days you come home and you're like, that was the best day of my life, and then other days you come home and you're like, ow. But you get up and you go again, and it's fantastic.
He's just kind of like a general, you know. He's a war general. We're out there, we're in the battlefield, and we're doing it, and it's fun. You know, it gets to be hard. You know, I do start counting down the days to getting my life back. But, you know, the first 5 months, pretty cool.
Each day tops the last. Really, because it's always something that, I mean, especially for me, I'd never been even on the set of something like this. So, you know, we're like in Stonehenge and things are exploding and you're like, I don't think that could top anything. And then someone's hanging out of a helicopter and you're like, oh, I guess we did.
I'll tell you a funny story. We were at Stonehenge. Mm-hmm. And he came into my dressing room, my trailer. He said, so this is the real Stonehenge. I said, yeah, I know. He said, we've built our own down there so we can explode bombs. I said, he said, ours is better than theirs. I said, only an American would say that.
What's up, guys? So if you're just joining us, I am live on the Transformers The Last Night red carpet here in Chicago, and I am here joined by Peter Cullen and Frank Welker, who are the voices of Optimus Prime and Megatron, respectively. You guys have been the voices of these characters since the first iteration. Are you surprised by where the franchise has gone?
Yes, very much so. 1984 to 2007, wow, it's mind-boggling. You know, it's a phenomenon to me.
How about you, Frank?
Oh, yeah, it's been crazy to think that this has gone on that long, and to work with my buddy Peter has been a pleasure and a thrill, and I love the franchise.
Were you guys worried at all that you wouldn't get the call when these movies started to happen?
Oh, of course. I had to audition for Optimus Prime all over.
Really?
Yeah. But, you know, that's a lot of water under the bridge, 2007 from 1986. So there are a lot of people that didn't know who he was. You know, things change. But I did get the part again.
Right.
So
yeah, we're here today. Is there a certain, like, were you surprised to see that Optimus Prime is a villain in this movie? Did you have to channel a different part of him for this?
No, I've always called on memory how I created the character. It was my brother Larry, who was a Marine and a former Marine, and I just modeled Optimus Prime after him, his tone of voice, the way he carried himself, his leadership as a Marine, you know, never screaming and yelling and all that stuff. Just, my name is Optimus Prime.
You know. Oh, wow, nice. How about you, Frank? Where does the Megatron voice come from?
Well, I originally, when I was auditioning, I knew Peter was in there also, so I was just trying to come up with something different that he wouldn't do because he's going to get everything. So I was just trying to think back and come up with some weird voices, and I had this kind of scratchy sound and added a few other things. And eventually, when they became huge and Michael wanted to go a different kind of a direction with the size, then it sort of led into more of, I am Megatron, leader of the Decepticons.
I love the reverb on that here, too. Do you guys have favorite things to say in these characters' voices?
I'm sorry, what did you say?
Do you have a favorite thing to say in the Megatron voice?
I believe in peace through tyranny.
Oh, terrifying, truly terrifying. How about you, Peter?
I have one line that I particularly like, and that's, till all are one.
Amazing. So before I let you guys go, we actually have fans submitted something that they'd like you to say, Frank. It's this tweet right here. I'll let you say it.
Okay.
Wanted, dead or alive, Optimus Prime is an enemy of the state. To humanity, he must be destroyed.
That is amazing, and you really, really... No. You committed. I loved it. And then you totally made a fan's day. Let's see what's going on with Josh over at home base.
Hey, Gabby, I'm just geeking out over here. That was insane, yeah. Remy.
Really cool. Hearing Megatron actually talk was really cool.
This is Remy Adeleke making his film debut in Transformers The Last Night. You know how to make a debut, man. This is a hard movie to get into for people. How do you score this gig, man?
Wow, it's a long story, but to keep it short, I was at the right place at the right time. I got the phone call when I was in graduate school, and I took it, and I said, hey, you want to jump in this Transformers film? And I said, absolutely. Next day, I was on set filming.
Well, it's not that easy. We should say also that this guy has a background that's pretty impressive. You were a Navy SEAL.
Yes, sir.
That's got
to
factor into it, I would think. Give me a sense. So having been through that kind of process, mm-hmm. do you feel like just being on a film set is relatively easy compared to the day job?
It was like a walk in the park. But there were some times when Michael Bay really pushed me and had me do some things where, you know, I had to say to myself, am I going to live through this one? Am I going to be all right? Am I not going to break anything or hurt anything? But other than that, everything went awesome, and it was such an amazing experience working with him.
Is it true that watching Michael Bay in certain of his films actually inspired you to be a Navy SEAL? I read that somewhere. Is that true?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, growing up in the Bronx, New York, we didn't have much access to Navy SEALs. They weren't billboards or anything like that. And I remember my mom would take us to the movies, and she took me to go see Bad Boys. And that was the first time I saw two African-American men who had somewhat of the same demeanor I did and looked like me, and they were playing heroes. And then a year later, The Rock came out, and that was the first time I was exposed to Navy SEALs. And so after seeing that, I decided, you know what, if I'm ever turn my life around, that's exactly what I'm going to do. And so I went and did it.
So we should say, we were just chit-chatting before, this is your first film, and I think first red carpet then, right?
Yeah, absolutely. First film, first red carpet. I have done some commercials, but this is my first big project, period.
Have you seen the film yet on the big screen?
No, I've just seen a few pieces here and there, but so I'm so looking forward to watching it.
I've got one up on you. I saw it last night. IMAX 3D in all its epic glory. Yeah. I was saying to one of your co-stars earlier, it's kind of cool, like Michael Bay shoots people like so heroically.
Yeah,
it's I mean, give me a sense of sort of like what's a day on the set like. How would you describe it to your friends?
You show up on set, you get propped up, get your costume on and get your makeup done, and then you get Michael Bay shows up on set, and he's quick. He likes to come in, shoot a scene, get it done, and move on. So everything just moved very rapid and efficient as well.
Were you a Transformers fan? Do you remember the first time you saw one of the films?
The first time I saw Transformers, I was about 4 or 5. You know, I mean, I grew up in the 80s, just like you. So I grew up with the cartoons. Yes. From 2007 on, Transformers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I loved them all. So,
yeah. Two New York City kids found themselves in Chicago here at a Transformers premiere. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Have a blast tonight, and hopefully we'll see you in many more films to come.
Most definitely.
All right, thanks, man. Have a blast.
Good
to see you, buddy.
Good to see you too.
Thanks. Let's take a look at, we were just talking about sort of the large-scale filmmaking in this. The way to see it, if you can, is in IMAX, and we've got a little kind of piece of video talking about the epic way these films are shot, a little featurette about the IMAX nature of this film. Check it out.
In cinema, I'm always trying to push the boundaries, and it's really to give you the very best experience.
The bigger the film, the more important it is to go to the theater, and Transformers are big films.
I want to get more activity from you guys. Come on. This is IMAX camera. You know how big that is on IMAX? You guys are huge on that screen.
It's amazing the world that Michael has created. He continues to make them bigger and better.
It gets bigger and more grand every time you go out, and I think part of that has to do with how IMAX keeps getting bigger and better.
Ready, guys? Here we go.
We are shooting with IMAX 3D. I'm the type that believes if you're going to do 3D, you're shooting real 3D.
We get that 3D right here?
That means two cameras, two eyes, and see exactly what you're seeing and not faking it.
That was, I would say, our go-to camera, A camera, always on the crane, always doing the big shots.
We strapped two IMAX Alexa cameras together onto a 3D rig.
It has a look like no other camera on the market. It's one of the most beautiful, incredible images you can see on a movie screen.
We are the very first blockbuster to shoot not 10 minutes, not 15 minutes of IMAX footage, but 98% IMAX footage.
IMAX, you really can see the scale, you can hear the sound and the whole experience that you get there. That's a big deal.
The 3D is phenomenal. Shooting 3D is harder, more expensive, but it is so worth the effort.
The operation is over.
We're not giving up on Prime, okay?
Hey guys, one of the treats of the Transformers series is seeing a new exciting talent, and Isabella Munair is certainly that. Welcome to Chicago, welcome to the red carpet for Transformers The Last Night. Good to see you, Isabella.
Thank you, good to see you too, Josh.
So let's talk about being a part of this amazing film series. First of all, let's go back. Okay, 10 years ago, you were how old when Transformers came out?
I think I was 6.
Okay, so
the wise age of 6.
Yeah, you knew back then.
Yeah.
One day I'm going to be in a Transformers film, obviously. What, do you remember the first time you saw a Transformers film? Was it a big deal?
Yeah, I actually saw all three. There were only three out at the time, but my brothers kind of made me go
on the bed with them and watch it. And I watched them in marathon form, and I had a huge crush on Shia, and I thought Megan was just the most beautiful person in the world, and yeah, that was kind of how I got hooked.
Is it still surreal for you to see yourself on the big screen in this? It must be mind-blowing to see the way Michael captures images and to see yourself in the context of this series. It's awesome.
Yeah, I can see all my pimples and all my teenage things. Yeah, no, in 3D too, so it's even better. It's spectacular, especially after spending 6 months every single day working our asses, butts off, PG-13. I had such a wonderful time too with everyone, and everyone was super cool, and now that I get to see them all glammed up and not covered in fake dirt and fake blood, it's much better.
This is the fun part. You can relax on a night like tonight. Let's talk about stunts, because a Transformers film, it's not necessarily an easy shoot, nor should it be, because you're rolling around, you're running, you're doing all sorts of crazy things. Were you prepared for how tough it was going to be, and did you enjoy it?
I trained about a month and a half before. I can't say I enjoyed the running, but I did like the stunts. The stunts were great. I always wanted to do my own stunts, and Michael Bay wanted me to do them too. But when it came down to my mom and the child labor law enforcers, they were biting their nails, like clenching their jaws and everything. But I really enjoyed the stunts. That was fun.
Who in your family or friends and family is most impressed? Who have you gained like the most like points with by being a part of this series?
Well, I think like if you've ever had a 19-year-old brother, you'll know that they don't get excited about too much.
Right.
But my 19-year-old brother is like a little boy again especially when he first saw the movie. He was like, "Oh my God, I'm like one of the first people ever to see the movie," and he got super excited for me. So
you're the cool sister. Congratulations.
Now I'm the cool sister. Before I was just annoying.
All it took was a gigantic summer blockbuster directed by Michael Bay.
You guys can do it too.
You can dream. Congratulations, Isabella. Have a blast tonight. Welcome to Chicago. It's a fun venue.
Woo! Yeah, Chicago.
That was just for you.
I feel so honored.
Have a blast tonight. Good to see you.
Thank you so much. Good to see you too.
Gabby, what's going on where you are?
Well, I am here on the red carpet, and that honk was a nice reminder that we are on a barge on the Chicago River. I'm here on the red carpet for the Transformers The Last Night premiere with Santiago Cabrera. How are you doing, man?
I'm doing very good. This is exciting. A lot of people, and this is a very unique red carpet, that's for sure.
Definitely. Have you ever been on a red carpet that has a bunch of tugboats and stuff walking by? Sailing by.
No, never. But it's a Michael Bay film, so you know, he definitely tops the game every time.
For sure. How big of a deal was it for you to be part of this franchise?
It's great. It's just super exciting. It's so huge, and you're introduced to a whole new world and a whole new bunch of fans, and just to see how invested they are in these movies, it's just amazing to be part of it.
And how was it working with Michael Bay?
Michael's just, it's sort of, it's more than what you could ever expect. It's super exciting. You don't know what's going to happen every day, and it just makes every day of work just very unique, that's for sure.
Were you a big fan of the franchise before getting involved?
I was actually a huge fan of the Transformers as a kid. I had the toys, I watched the cartoons, and then I watched the films once I was involved, and you realize you're coming to something huge.
Were you more of an Optimus Prime or a Bumblebee guy?
I think probably a Bumblebee guy, yeah.
That's the right answer.
Although I got into a fight with him in this movie, so we had a little scrap there, which was great.
Right. What are those scenes like where you're acting with something that isn't there?
Well, there's as much there as possible. Michael tries to make it feel as real as can be. So, the car's there and the pieces are there, and there's someone holding a pole with the face of whoever you're talking to there. So it's enough for it to be believable.
Cool. Who in your life is most excited about you being a part of this franchise?
I think my little boy, although he doesn't get it yet. He's 14 months, but in a couple of years, he's going to be super excited, that's for sure.
Does he have the toys and stuff too?
He will definitely get them as soon as he's of age.
Hopefully we'll get you one too, a little Santos action figure or something.
Yeah, that's what I got to get on, a little Santos action figure for sure.
So how did you prepare for this stunt work in this film?
Well, I got, I play a team leader, a mercenary who's like an ex-Navy SEAL, so having those guys on board with me, they, on set, my whole team was made of Navy SEALs, so I was training with them every morning and, you know, learning about their world and their reality and how to use, you know, how to look like you know how to use guns, that kind of stuff. So
yeah, what kind of tips did they give you?
Well, just how to walk with it, the formation point, and then, you know, and what stuff to say on the radio, and a lot of stuff, a lot of lines, a lot of scenes and moments we would find. You know, Michael comes up with stuff in the moment, so it was great to have them there to kind of be authentic in the wording and the phrasing of stuff.
For sure, and getting all those details down is particularly important when everyone's watching it in IMAX 3D.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely.
Cool, well, I cannot wait. I hope that you are very happy and feel like...
Super happy, super excited to be here, and super excited to see it, actually, because I haven't seen it yet, and to see all the pieces come together is great, so I'm looking forward to it.
Awesome, dude, congratulations. Let's see what's going on with Josh Horowitz over on the other end of the carpet.
Hey, Gabby. Look, I'm here with my twin, Mr. Josh Stumel.
Yes.
Good to see you, buddy.
Good to see you, Josh.
Congratulations, man. You can't spell Transformers without Josh Stumel. Come on.
Actually, you can.
Okay, you're great. I'm not good at spelling. Yeah. Congratulations, though, man, on return to the series. Give me a sense. Let's take a look back. Let's go back, okay. All the way back. Where were you in your life when you heard the word Transformers for the first time? And was it kind of a no-brainer? Was it a big moment to be a part of that series, about that first film?
Yeah, I remember it was before Ferg and I even started dating, I think. No, it was right around the time we started dating. It was the second year I was doing a show called Las Vegas, and it was such a huge opportunity for me. And to think back, that was like 10, 11 years ago now, is unbelievable. So, you know, we were here, the last time I shot one of these, we were here in Chicago. We shut down Michigan Avenue for, it felt like months. I can't believe they invited us back, actually, because I thought the people of Chicago hated us forever. But it's been an amazing ride. I've seen places I never thought I'd see. I've been able to do things I'd never thought I'd do. And I get to be a part of a franchise that's international. I love it.
Does being part of like this scale of filmmaking kind of prepare you for anything in a sense? I mean, very few films of this sheer magnitude are made nowadays. And I would think that you get some skills, some odd skills maybe, but you get some interesting skills that you can apply to other parts of your life or other parts of acting.
Definitely. I mean, it's a completely different way of making movies. Yeah. I've learned that now because I've been doing it for 10 years, but the way Michael Bay makes movies is... it's an exercise in spontaneity. It's an exercise in just being ready for anything. You know, normally you'd read a script, you'd rehearse the scene with the other person, and then you'd go and you'd do the scene.
Right.
Here, it's like you don't even know if you're going to be doing that scene that day. And if you do that scene, it's going to be completely different than what's on the page. So you have to just come ready for anything. And that makes everybody on set, not just the actors, but everybody on the crew, ready for whatever. And it makes everybody bring their A game, which is an exciting place to live. Yeah. Frustrating, but exciting.
Well, I would think people would be surprised. Like, you think of big films, you think like lumbering films that move slowly. I've been on a Transformers set, and I've seen how quickly everybody's got to move, because he's got 1,000 ideas going in his head. You just got to adapt and go with it. Talk to me a little bit about seeing yourself on the big screen, like the first time in a Transformers film. I've been saying to some of your co-stars, like, nobody captures like those hero shots like Michael. I mean, you look like just, you know, the coolest guy on the planet.
If I could tell you how nerdy I feel when I'm actually shooting it, how insecure and insignificant I feel on that set, because you're a tiny little cog in this giant machine, and you just feel, oh my God, I screwed that scene up completely. I'm going to look like an absolute idiot. And then you see it on the movie, you're like, wow, he really made me look cool. So that's just a testament to Michael and how cool he can make people look. Because trust me, I did not feel cool.
Yeah, do you feel a little crazy when you have to be talking to, like, you know, like a 30-foot Optimus Prime? Do you ever get over that 4 films in?
Yes, this time around it felt a lot more comfortable. It took me a couple movies to figure out, you know, that, okay, I can trust that giant pole with the face of, you know, Megatron is going to be a real, you know, Transformer someday. So just let your mind go there and just imagine it, and that's it.
People don't realize I'm a CGI creation by Michael Bay. They've wasted $10 million on this live stream. He's talking to a tennis ball right now.
You are incredibly handsome.
Talk to me a little bit about, so is Axel ready for, probably not ready for a Transformers film. What's
he's coming. Yeah. He's coming tonight.
Yeah,
I might be the worst father in the world, but he's coming.
Do you have some, do you get some brownie points in your extended family, friends, about being in this series of films? I would think that's kind of a, you get some cool points.
So I have about 25 people here from, I have a bunch of friends who live in Minneapolis, and they just drove up. And so they brought all their kids, so we got a whole crew of people that are coming through tonight. Nice. And to me, that's the most important part. I just love the fact that all these, not just my friends, but their kids get to come and enjoy it. Yeah. You know, we were at dinner last night. There's about 25 of us at the dinner table, and about half of them are kids. Kids that I've known since they were born.
Sure.
And they're so excited to be here. They're nervous. They're like, oh my God, we're going to the Transformers premiere. I mean, what's better than that?
Pretty awesome. Yeah. Well, enjoy the night, man. I can't believe it's been 10 years of talking about Transformers film. When we started talking about this, he was just this tall, guys.
I was just a wee little lad.
The growth spurt is amazing. In 10 more years, you're going to be like Optimus.
That's the hope.
It's good to see you, buddy.
All right,
have
you
fun
too.
Tonight. Thanks, man.
Who's the best basketball player in the world?
LeBron James?
Steph Curry.
Get out of here. Just go. Let's take a look at a clip from Transformers The Last Night. He threw me off my game. Check it out.
That was for you, Ben Ryan.
We have guests.
Oh,
what's the matter with you?
Oh, take my bits of falling off.
Idiot.
What the hell?
Good God.
Master, he's a complete knucklehead.
I'm awfully sorry about that, but, you see, he thinks it's still the year 1918 or 1914, something like that, isn't it? I mean, it's late onset of, robot dementia. Not at all pretty.
Yeah. I don't know what you're smoking in that pipe, man, but what's going on here? Will you drag me to some Transformer retirement home?
Mm-hmm.
Look, somebody better start talking or I'm out of here.
Whoa, okay. Bumblebee? We only met when I was a little boy in short pants. I must have been that tall, maybe taller, or maybe shorter, I can't remember. But...
Oh, look with you!
Face.
Hey, you know this guy?
Oh, yeah. Let's have a look at this thing. Please. Very interesting. Yes. You keep a secret for so long, knowing it to be true, and yet deep down inside, you begin to wonder, has my life been wasted? Have you ever felt like that, Mr. Kane?
It's just Cade. Look, old timer, I don't have a ton of patience for riddles right now.
Yes, but you want to know, don't you, dude? Why they keep coming here to Earth. Right. Ah, I do so love perfect timing.
No, literally, why do you have to be like that?
So is this a kidnapping sort of situation or her first Transformer experience?
It's both, really.
She's very difficult!
Hey guys, welcome back to Chicago to the U.S. premiere of Transformers The Last Night. I was saying before, always fun to talk to some returning characters and actors like Josh Duhamel, but also exciting to welcome some new actors to the mix. Laura Haddock, it's good to see you, Laura.
Good to see you.
Let's talk a little bit about Vivian, the new character that joins the universe of Transformers this time around. What was appealing about this character? What made this exciting for you?
When I first read the part, I was really encouraged by how tough she was and how strong she was and how intelligent she was. And she had this wonderful, witty rapport with Mark's character, Cade Yeager, and they're obviously from two completely different worlds and they may as well be speaking different languages. But there's this great opportunity to have a really fun, like, kind of comic sparring match, I think, with him, and I loved that. She's strong, and she's as strong as the guys, and she's not a damsel in distress, and that was exciting to me.
I've been talking to some of your co-stars about this. You can't be in a Transformers movie and not be expected to do some massive amount of running and jumping and rolling. And certainly, having seen the film, I saw it last night, it's epic. You do as much, if not more, than anybody in the film. You've got like a really great character and some very cool stunts to do in the film. Were they cool, or were they like, oh my God, this is going to kill me if they don't actually work? Give me a sense of what it was like to do this kind of stunt work.
I mean, I was counting the bruises every night. Yeah, Michael likes his actors to really throw themselves into the stunts. So I was doing a lot of them along with my stunt double, Jess Harbeck, who's here tonight. I brought her as my guest tonight because it really is teamwork in a film like this. And I completely embraced all the stunts and all the action. As I said, Michael loves you to do that, and I was completely game. So, but you are counting the bruises. And yeah, you are strapped up for 99% of the time.
But they're probably badges of honor. You go home, you're like, hey, look at this. I'm a real action star now.
Exactly, exactly.
It's funny, you referenced this earlier. I mean, like, you get to do the stunts, but you also get to do these really fun scenes, and I'm thinking of a couple in particular, where it's you and Mark and basically Sir Anthony Hopkins. And that's like, that's a unique opportunity. You don't necessarily think in like a giant summer blockbuster to get some like chewy, fun dialogue. And you really actually do have some fun stuff to do in it. Were those kind of like the easier days? Were they almost more fun in a way to kind of do that kind of stuff too?
Oh, I mean, I enjoyed both things equally, but that working with Anthony and Mark was so brilliant. They're both so open to the improvisation and Anthony was just so brilliant at saying the words on the page and then just peppering them with a little Anthony Hopkins humor at the end and would just floor Mark and I. But Mark is extremely funny. There was a lot of corpsing going on. Sure. Yeah, so that all that stuff was great fun.
So what about the fact, I mean, this is a global series, a global, you've been traveling the world for this, you'll continue to. It's a rare opportunity for an actor to be a part of something that you know, I mean, you know, if you're going to talk numbers, it's made almost $4 billion.
Yeah, I remember when I first met Michael, he told me the figures. And I was like, God, no
it's
pressure.
All on you now, Laura.
Yeah, no pressure.
I mean, did you go back and look at the other films? Had you already seen them? And were you kind of like, did you know what you were getting into?
Yeah, I'd watched the films already, so I was already a fan and I was already into the franchise. So I didn't have to do too much homework in that sense. But yeah, you're right. It was daunting joining such an enormous machine, but you very quickly become part of the family and relaxed, and then all of a sudden, you're in it.
Yeah. Who in your family, extended family, friends is most? Who do you get like the most brownie points from? From being a part of this, who's the most excited about you being a part of the Transformers series?
They're all really excited. But I remember going home sometimes, and Sam, my husband, would say to me, "You know, what have you done today?" And I would say, "Oh, I've just been driving Bumblebee through Detroit, being chased by a load of Decepticons," right. And he would just be looking at me like. What? That's a pretty cool thing for my wife to be able to say. So yeah.
You're like Hunger Games, Schmunger Games, whatever, Sam. I got Bumblebee. All right.
Yeah, exactly.
Would you rather? Here's a stupid question. Would you rather change your name to Optimus Prime or Cade Yeager? I love the names in the Transformers series. Come on, how good a name is Cade Yeager as a leading man? Come on.
Yeah, I know. That's who came up with that?
Oh, no, they're a genius, though. They're a genius.
And Vivian Wembley is so British.
Classic British. You have to be British if you're named Vivian. Absolutely. If you're from Jersey and you're named Vivian Wembley, something's wrong.
Exactly. It's off. Something's off.
I've been asking also your co-stars about just seeing yourself on the big screen in a Michael Bay film, in a Transformers film. What's it like? I mean, everybody looks fabulous and just like so heroic. It must be sort of mind-boggling to see yourself in that context.
Completely mind-boggling. Michael is just such a genius at creating movies like this and putting them on the big screen. And when the first time I watched it in IMAX in 3D, and it's such a rightful home for that movie because you feel like you're part of it and it's surrounding you and you're wrapped up in it. I mean, I literally was, but when I was in the cinema, I felt like I was again. And it's such a good home. Michael wants all of his fans to feel like they're part of the experience. Yeah. And I think IMAX and 3D certainly does that. So, it's mad. Yeah. It's mad. Yeah. I could never have imagined.
I will say audiences will get their money's worth going IMAX 3D. You've got 2.5 hours of sheer entertainment. It's pretty awesome.
Yeah.
Laura, it's always good. Congratulations on being a part of this, and have fun in this beautiful venue, Chicago, the Opera House. We're at the Opera.
I know. Chicago's awesome. I've never been. This is my first time. It's amazing here. Yes, I'm excited.
Enjoy yourself. Oh. Thanks so much for stopping
Thank
by.
Thank you so much.
Gabby, what's going on where you are?
Hey, Josh. Well, we are still here on the Transformers The Last Night red carpet here live in Chicago, and I am here with Julio Cesar Chavez.
Yes,
a newcomer to the Transformers franchise.
Yes, ma'am.
So tell me about getting this role. What was the audition process like?
Well, the audition process was fun. I auditioned with other kids. Then I didn't get a callback because I was working on a film. So
Wow, just drop that. Yeah.
Yes. Well, I was working on the film. My manager had called me like, yeah, you didn't get the callback. I'm like, oh, well, you know, it happens. Maybe better stuff happens.
So it sounds like you're an industry vet. Is this your first red carpet?
Actually, I've done other ones, but this is my first huge red carpet.
Nice. And what does it mean to you to be a part of this huge franchise?
It means to me a lot. I love Bayham. I mean, working with Mr. Michael Bay, he's one of the best directors in the whole world. I love working with him. It was really fun.
Yeah, what was that experience like? What was it like on set?
It was... At the beginning, it was a little tough. Then I a little getting used to. But then after that, I was like, oh, it's awesome. I really love working with Michael Bay. He's so cool. I love the explosions everywhere.
Right,
so
there's a lot of screaming and running.
Yes, it felt like we were being attacked. We were, but it was really fun. I love it.
What was it like reacting to Transformers that like aren't actually there, but as best that they could be?
It was actually really fun. I would see a couple clouds, but it was really fun. I really loved working in Transformers.
Well, you have a fire fit here today. Do you want to do a little spin for the camera and talk a little bit about why you put this together?
Well, I really love this outfit. My mom helped me pick that out a little bit. She's like, "Ooh, this would be cute." Like,
shouts to mom.
Shout out to my mama, my pops, and my whole family, Guatemala Mexicans, and these shoes. Which when I picked them out, I was like, ooh, Aquaman. But then one of my friends, I'm working on a film right now, he's like, dude, I love your Maserati shoes. I'm like, oh yeah, I was like, oh sure, you know, I'm gonna wear them just for you, bro. I was like, Isaac Crackton, that's my friend right there.
And very fitting for this franchise too, all the like hot cars.
Oh yeah, I love the cars. They're so beautiful, they're so gorgeous. Just amazing cars, I really love them, they're really nice.
Who are you more starstruck to be in a movie with, Mark Wahlberg or Optimus Prime?
That's a tough decision. I'll actually go with Mark Wahlberg.
Yeah.
Even though I love Optimus, he's not my favorite Transformer. My favorite Transformer is Bumblebee. I mean, come on.
That's mine too. It's
okay. Cool. But I love working with Mark Wahlberg. He's so fun and funny. I remember we were on set one time and we were trying to take a picture and he pull out his muscles like you want to film my mongos? Like, oh, cool. It was like. Woo! It was really funny. He's really funny.
You have scenes with Mark, right?
I've seen, what was that? I'm sorry?
You have scenes with Mark in the movie.
Oh, yes, ma'am. I have scenes with Mark.
Yeah, what was that like?
It was serious and funny at the same time. It was a nice experience. I really loved it.
Awesome. Well, congratulations. And I can't wait for you to see yourself on that big screen, that big IMAX 3D screen. For now, we're going to take out another clip from the movie.
Hey, someone get Optimus a chair!
These the legs.
Yeah, it's kind of a tricky chair.
This should be easy.
You're just gonna want to fold it out? Just unfurl it?
Hang on.
Let me help you.
Wait a minute.
You're gonna transform the chair, get it? Don't step on me!
I'll just stand.
Transformers The Last Night, rated PG-13.
Hey guys, as you can see, I'm with the man of the hour, the man that is really responsible for this amazing series. Congratulations, Mr. Michael Bay, on the
Thank
fifth installment
much.
In this amazing series.
Thank you. What were you going to say?
Well, I was going to say, I was talking to you before when you just walked up here. You know, we've talked, I think, after each one of these, and it's This is tough movie making. This is, and you are a perfectionist. I know that about you. Just give me a sense of how you're feeling just when you deliver that final print.
Well, they take the print from you, basically. I finished this movie 2 days before I left for China, but I could have kept going. A movie this size, we do it in about 18 months. 3,000 people work on these movies, and that's a lot of love, sweat, and tears, you know? So.
How do you raise the bar? Because I mean, you know, on each one of these, if you quit after the first one, you had redefined sort of how blockbusters were made, and then you do it four more times. After the fourth one, what did you need to do in this one to make it worth your while, to make it worthy of your time?
It started with a phone call from Steven Spielberg saying, a movie called Transformers, it's about a boy who finds a car that's an alien robot. From there, it starts as a sweet movie, right? And then it becomes, each one gets bigger. We try to be a little more spectacular, but you always got to focus on the characters. And this one focuses a lot on mythology and where it could spin off from now. You know, it's been a great ride for me of 10 years doing this, 5 movies. It's been like a family affair. And sad to say goodbye, you know?
Well, I was going
to
say, and you know where I'm going, because every time, again, when we talk after you finish this movie, you say, I'm probably done. I think I'm done. Yes, I'm done.
No,
and then in 6 months later, you're like, wait a second.
Five's good. It is sad. You're right. It is sad, okay? But 5's good.
But it also must feel, I mean, nearly $4 billion in count. You've touched many lives with this series.
Yeah.
It's really resonated. I mean,
I'm very humbled by that, and I'm humbled that the fans have stuck with me doing this franchise and that they've embraced it. So it's a really nice feeling.
What do you think the legacy is that you've left on this series, on the Transformers name?
I don't know. You can't talk about your own legacy.
Well, I mean, talk to me a little bit about sort of like, is there it's hard to pinpoint even one film, but like a scene or a sequence. When you look back at these 5 films, is there one that you're like, you know what? I came as close to what I had in my head on that scene as possible.
You know what? When Steven told me this idea, I didn't like it at first. I hung the phone up and I'm like, I don't really like that. And I went to Hasbro and I started doing research. But I had this image in my head. I said, first of all, if I can make the robots really real, okay? That was one thing. But two, I had this image of a boy hiding 5 robots behind his house with his parents there. And he can't let his parents know. And to me, that was such the wish fulfillment kind of idea. And that's kind of how I hooked my head into the movie.
Is there a kind of actor that you think is well suited to your kind of filmmaking? I've seen the way you've run a set. You move quickly. They've got to keep up.
I like all sorts of actors. You know, the one I didn't like was Anthony Hopkins.
No. Overrated. I mean, that guy's the best. He's amazing.
He's fantastic. And he's you know, he said to me, he goes, I love doing this because no one allows me to be funny.
He's very funny in the film. There's some really funny stuff, like just even between him and Mark and Laura.
Yeah.
Just on a purely dialogue level, some really fun scenes.
You could see there's a couple scenes where Mark's about to crack up, and we use a take because Anthony only said it once in an improv line.
Right.
Oh, she's impatient about something.
This is
your director.
The
director's going like this. She's like this with the thing.
Sammy's doing a dance for us because she wants us to show a clip from your amazing film.
Oh, okay.
Congratulations.
Toss clip from movie.
Congratulations on this amazing series. If this is
your jacket, is getting more blue.
He's directing my wardrobe.
Like
you want to switch?
No.
You're looking dapper as always. Enjoy the Chicago night. The Opera House, man. You went big.
I want one of those cars that blow up. I'm going to put it in my bedroom.
I think you can probably make that happen.
Yeah.
Good to see you, Michael. Take a look at this clip from Transformers: The Last Night.
Wow.
What's up?
Does he have to loom like that?
Bonjour, chérie.
That's a nice ride. I mean, you can roll right at the Buckingham Palace in that thing.
Okay, you, American man, shut it. What am I doing here?
Yeah, why is she here?
Introductions. Miss Vivian Wembley, Master of History, Oxford, Doctor of Philosophy, also Oxford, and Doctor of Letters again, Oxford, I think. Anything else? Anyway, meet Cade.
Jaeger. Cade Jaeger. I'm an inventor.
Oh, you're an inventor.
Yes, I am.
What have you invented?
A lot of things.
Like?
Like a lot of things. Like things that you've heard of.
Like?
Well, things that you will have heard of, okay? Patents are pending.
Ah.
Ah. Don't say it. What's up? You know, I could do that too. Oh, I'm English and I'm too cool for feelings. What, I'm not? I've come here to be insulted by some overeducated Ivy Tower princess?
Go! What's the problem? No, 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 no!
To me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
To this? Hey guys, we are almost at the end of our amazing live stream in Chicago for Transformers The Last Night, but we can't end the show without both Gabby and...
Oh, look who I brought! I brought the man of the hour, Mark Wahlberg.
Mark?
I thought you said I was going to get to talk to you.
I can leave.
She lured me up. I knew it was a trick.
I know, there was a whole ruse where I was going to escort him.
No, no, no. How are you? Thank you. Hi, Josh.
It's good to see you, buddy.
I still love you.
I love you.
I love you more now.
Should I leave?
No, yesterday. No, we all love each other here.
What is that great song? I love you more today than I loved you yesterday, but not as much as tomorrow.
I don't think we have the rights to that.
So, it's beautiful. Oh, he's going to cry. His lip is quivering. Is that just because you're on the
it's
the
a little
river
cold,
here?
It's a little nippy.
Oh.
I know, it is pretty cold. At least you got a jacket.
Why don't you offer the lady your jacket, Josh?
No, it's fine. I'm fine. This is about you, Mark, and this amazing movie.
Can we talk about giant robots?
Sure.
You're in a Transformers movie again.
Why not?
Congratulations.
Well, thank you. I appreciate it.
Have you won any brownie points with the kids? Do they care one iota that you are Mr. Cade Yeager? Whoa, what's going on?
Traffic.
I thought that was sound effects. They saw the movie today. They loved it, but they still...
Nothing.
I hate you, Dad. You're the worst dad ever.
Do they get a grip of free stuff?
They did. They got a whole theater to themselves. They had popcorn. They had ice, cherry ices, blue ices, and then nothing.
Did you have authorization over the name of your character? I love the name Cade Yeager. It's like my favorite character name in movies currently, I think.
I didn't. That was a Bay thing. You know, I don't even get to decide what pants I wear. I don't even get to decide the level of tightness that the pants are, you know? It's like when we were talking about the hair, I was like, well, I don't want to have long hair. And he was like, no, you're on the run now. You've got to have long hair. I'm like, but what if you're on the run? You could shave your head, right?
That's true, but it'll just grow back.
Economical, yeah.
Yeah, but I mean, we never discuss time. Logic goes out the window when it comes to certain things in these movies.
Did you at least get to pick what brand of baby oil they rub all over your body?
I don't know. I had no baby oil.
Oh, that was just your sweat.
Dwayne Johnson has a lock on all baby oil. You're not allowed contractually to wear or apply baby oil in a Paramount picture.
It's just aqua hydrate all over you.
So, yes, I can throw aqua hydrate. I can spritz. But they will come and test the level of oil within the bottle.
Okay.
Before you walk on set.
There's no segue, so let's just move on. You've done your fair amount of stunts over the years.
Yes.
Is there one in particular when you think back to these last two films that made you second guess what you were doing with your life?
Oh, God. The most fearful stunt that we performed was in the first movie on the roof of that building in Hong Kong.
Right.
Because it was just like one little cable, you know, run as fast as you can. Michael's throwing debris at you. And, you know, you're harnessed in, but you're still going to hang over the side of the building and wet your pants and probably do a little bit more than that. But there was more demanding physical stunts in this particular movie, and I'm 46. Yeah. And I know if I walk into my trailer and there's a harness on my couch, it's a bad day. It's just a bad day. But there was, out of 90-something shooting days, there was 80-something days of wearing the harness.
Right.
Do you do all of your own stunts?
I only do the ones that are required of me, which is more than enough in this particular movie. I mean, if I'm walking down the street and I see a guy that looks remotely like me, I will recruit him to be a stuntman.
Major blockbuster.
Like, even Josh, I'll pump him up, shave him down.
This is turning into a very different kind of live stream.
So it is, it would be, I would prefer not to. I'm not, you know, I'm not that guy.
Right.
Who's like, I've had enough real life experience where I'm not like, oh yes, I'll jump out of a building or, you know, throw me off of the roof. No, I'd rather not.
What type of actor is right for these kind of films? I've seen the way Michael runs a set. He moves quickly. You got to just know, like, be ready to adapt and move on and just do what you got to do, right?
I think, you know, for me personally, I signed on to service his vision. This guy is a great leader and a general, but, you know, he's got the whole movie in his head, and he's got to push this thing uphill every day single-handedly. So it was, you know, it was great. Here's a great example. We were working hard every day. It was 125 degrees in Arizona. It was difficult. Then we went to Detroit, worked hard there for 8 weeks, and then we went to London. And here comes Anthony Hopkins with this big smile on his face, just so happy to be there, full of energy, excitement, and enthusiasm every day. And we were all just like completely reminded how lucky we are to have these jobs and to be in this business. And he kind of made sure he set the tone for everybody else for the rest of the way. Both people, you know, the crew and the cast, which was awesome.
Do you still get a kick out? I mean, you've been making movies for decades now, but seeing yourself in a Michael Bay film, he shoots actors like nobody else. Those hero shots are pretty epic. It's still got to be a gas to see yourself on the big screen opposite giant robots just kicking ass.
Yeah, no, it's cool, but I'm kind of looking forward to transitioning into the elder statesman role, like Anthony Hopkins, where I could just kind of bark some orders and then sit there and say, go, get him. You can do it. We're counting on you. And then see somebody else get slapped around.
Again,
I
smart
think you
guy.
Give a ways off for that.
Yeah, give us a little more running and jumping and screaming, okay?
Please.
Okay. Yes,
for her at least.
Amazing.
I think that wraps up our live show. Mark, thank you for being with us. What's wrong? You're upset.
That's it?
That was it. Is there anything else inappropriate you want to do?
We have now replaced Josh Horowitz.
No.
He's about to make a plunge into the lake. No, Josh.
Still here. Mark, thanks for being with us. Everybody check out Transformers The Last Night. It is out in theaters right now. I'm Josh Horowitz.
I'm Gabby Wilson.
See you guys next time. That's Mark Wahlberg, by the way. Yeah.
I'm the old guy.
There's a sign. Did you see the sign, that heart? I think it says your name in there.
The
I was up there earlier, I put that up. Do you like it?
Shut up.
Good to see you, buddy.
All right, buddy.
Everybody good? Everybody's good. You're
good.